Hi, my class 9 friends. We are now going to solve Pythagoras theorem exercise number 11, question 15 from Frank Brothers Maths. Lots of you have told me that you don't like this question, so I decided to make a video on that. And let us see what the question is. In a triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC, CP perpendicular to AB, prove that number 1, 2AB into BP equal to BC square, and second one, CP square minus BP square is equal to 2AP into BP. So whenever we have a question like this, first thing we have to do is to draw the diagram. In our diagram, AB is equal to AC, so we'll have AB is equal to AC, and CP is perpendicular, so we have drawn this perpendicular to AB. Now prove that 2AB into BP is equal to BC square. So let us say that you are totally stuck about this. First thing we can do is at least we can divide the page into two halves. We can write the statements, we can write the reasons, we can write the proof. And first thing we'll write is AB equal to AC. And because they are going to be equal, let us call them as X and X. Okay, this is given. Now, can you see the right triangles? Yes, you can. Which are the two right triangles? We will have BPC, that is this right triangle. Now, in this right triangle, by Pythagoras theorem, opposite 90 is BC square. BC square will be equal to BP square plus BC square. All right. Which is the other right triangle? This one. In that, you will see, according to Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AP square plus BC square. Now, because we have to have the value of BC square as this, BC square we got over here equal to BP square plus PC square. So we have BP and PC here. And in the second triangle, we have no BP, no BC, but we have PC. So what we are going to do is we are going to get the value of PC square. So PC square is, take AP square this side, so it becomes AC square minus AP square. Okay, AP square went that side, it became minus AP square. Alright, now do we know that in our proof we have to have AB, but we have been given AC. But we know that AC and AB, they are equal. So in place of AC, we will substitute AB because of this statement number one. Got that? Now, our BC square, that is this statement, becomes BP square as it is. And in place of PC square, we are going to write AB square minus AP square that we got from here. All right? And we write our reasons from statement number 2 and 3. Statement number 2 was this, which we repeated, and 3 said that PC square is equal to AB square minus AP square. Alright, now look again out here, BC square. So we have BC square and BC square. But this side we have AB and BP. So we already have BP here and we need AB. So we have AB, but do we need AP here? No, we need BP. So look over here, AP, look at the diagram. Your AP and BP, how are they connected? From the diagram, can you see that this AP is AB minus BP? Pause it and see once again. AB is going to be subtracted with BP and then we will get AP. So we write in place of AP, we will write AB minus BB. Alright, this is from the diagram. Now because it's a whole square, we are just going to expand this. So this is, as it is, BP square, this is AB square. And here inside the bracket, we will use the formula A minus B whole square equal to A square minus 2AB plus B squared. So this is your AB square minus 2AB into PB plus PB square. Alright, next we open the brackets. When we open the brackets, BP square plus ab square as it is, and each one of these will change signs. So minus ab square plus 2ab into pb minus pb square. Now you will see that this pb square and this bp square get cancelled. Ab square and this ab square get cancelled. And so we have only 2ab into pb remaining. So we say bc square is equal to 2ab into pb, and that is our first proof. Now for the second part, we are expected to find cp square minus bp square is equal to 2ap into bp. Now cp square minus bp square, so we will write just that. We will write the way it has been given. We can't see the diagram here. So we will keep one diagram here. I have cut out one paper so that you can see the diagram. Now, cp square minus bp square was equal to something. Now, what is cp square? Now, cp square, does it have its value in terms of ap? So, for cp square, in terms of ap, if I have to take the value, I must take this triangle. So, cp square will be equal to ac square minus ap square, which is what we have already seen in statement number 3. If you go back, you will see that. All right. Now we have BP here. We have BP here, but in our statement, we need AP as well. And we don't need BP square. We need only BP. So BP square that we have, we will have to write in terms of AP. So we will write your BP as AB minus AP. See that? AB minus AP from the diagram. Now, once you have this, this portion remains the same here. We copy it as it is. And here we will use the formula a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b squared. And that is how we will get ab squared minus 2ab into ap plus ap squared. Then we will just simplify this by opening the bracket. See here, the bracket opens. This as it is, and this becomes minus ab squared. This becomes 2ab into ap, and here it becomes minus ap square. Now remember, in our expression over here, we see ac square and ab square. Now both of these are equal, so we had taken them as x. So ac becomes x squared, ac square becomes x squared, minus ap square as it is, this becomes minus x squared, this remains as it is, and this becomes minus ap squared. All right. So you have x squared getting cancelled, and we will have 2ab into ap, and minus ap square and ap square will give us 2ap square. So you will see ap and ap, they are common in these two terms. So 2ap is common. Inside the bracket, you'll have ab minus ap. Now look at the diagram. Ab minus ap is bp, correct? And so we will have ab minus ap is bp. And so we have 2ap into bp, and that is your cp square minus bp square. And that is how we prove the second part as well. All right. So we are going to end this video over here. Keep in mind that my online course is being prepared. So those who are not having direct access to my teaching, you will be soon getting your own online course. And so keep looking in the description. It may take some time. All right. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Hope you understood everything. Thank you for watching.